Now we will pray the novena. Ninth and final day. Today bring to me souls who have become lukewarm and immerse them in the abyss of my mercy. These souls wound my heart most painfully. My soul suffered the most dreadful loathing in the Garden of Olives because of lukewarm souls. They were the reason I cried out, "Father, take this cup away from me, if it be your will." For them, the least hope of salvation is to run to my mercy. Most compassionate Jesus, your compassion itself, I bring lukewarm souls into the abode of your most compassionate heart. In this fire of your pure love, let these tepid souls, who like corpses filled you with such deep loathing, be once again set aflame. O most compassionate Jesus, exercise the omnipotence of your mercy and draw them into the very ardor of your love and bestow upon them the gift of holy love. For nothing is beyond your power. Eternal Father, turn your merciful gaze upon lukewarm souls who are nonetheless enfolded in the most compassionate heart of Jesus. Father of mercy, I beg you by the bitter passion of your Son and by his 3-hour agony on the cross, let them too glorify the abyss of your mercy. Amen. The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We shall pray together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
for the sake of his sorrowful passion,
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, for the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, for the sake of his sorrowful passion. 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 Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We shall pray together. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Jesus, I trust in you. The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Let's call to mind our shortcomings and failures. Ask God's pardon and forgiveness for the worthy celebration of this most holy Eucharist. Lord Jesus, you came to call us sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again. Glory to judge the living and the dead. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindled the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power the apostles bore witness in the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles. And they were distributed to each according to their need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I sent you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Second Sunday in the season of Easter is also known as the Divine Mercy Sunday. Our God is compassionate and merciful. That's a theme we can find all throughout the scripture. Psalm number 145, verse 8, where it clearly says, our Lord is gracious, full of compassion, slow to anger, and rich in mercy. You know, in the Old Testament, we find God calls our patriarchs, or he calls the prophets, and through them, he revealed his mercy to the people of Israel. But in the fullness of time, God sends his only Son. And Jesus comes to reveal the true face of God. And what is the true face of God? Our God is compassionate and merciful. In the Gospels, especially Gospel of Luke, chapter 15, Jesus gives three parables. The parable of the lost coin, the parable of the lost sheep, and the parable of the lost son or the prodigal son. With these parables, Jesus tells very clearly, our God is merciful and compassionate. He is a forgiving God. He is ready and willing to give a second chance. And he invites everyone to experience his mercy. We begin the Divine Mercy Novena on the day of Good Friday. To Sister Faustina, Jesus himself reveals that he is merciful, he is compassionate, and invite everyone to experience His mercy. So why do we need to experience God's mercy? In the Beatitudes, Jesus says, blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. When we experience the mercy of God, that will enable us to be merciful to others. You know, every day in the news around us, we hear about a lot of injustice and violences, a lot of things not going right. One of the root causes is this world is in need of mercy. We need to be more compassionate and merciful to see the needs of our neighbors and be there for others. That's why to Sister Faustina, Jesus asked her to pray not only for herself, but for the whole world. That's why when we pray the Novena, the chaplet, divine chaplet, we are praying for the whole world, not really just for oneself. You know, Pope Francis had an extraordinary year of the year of mercy. Once again, we are trading the same message. Our God is merciful and compassionate. We need to approach Him to seek His mercy. The gospel passage of today, Jesus breathes on the apostles and gives them the power to forgive the sins. That's why we have the beautiful sacrament of reconciliation or confession. When we approach this great sacrament, we receive the mercy and forgiveness from the Lord. And as a conclusion, so tomorrow we will, 1 p.m., we will expose the Blessed Sacrament. And you will have the opportunity to approach the sacrament of reconciliation. And at 3 p.m., we will pray the divine chaplet, asking the Lord for being merciful to the whole world and the humanity. As we continue this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask the grace from Jesus that we may go to Him, experience His mercy, so that we can be merciful to one another. Please rise. We shall pray together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We have not seen, but still believe. With a confident faith, we bring our needs before our Heavenly Father.
That the power of the resurrection fills the church, empowering each Christian to spread the good news of the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of the risen Christ, which surpasses understanding, wash over our nation and world, bringing unity and harmony, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and newly received find in the church both welcome and challenge, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those seeking an increase in faith will grow in certainty that God's divine mercy is abundant and beyond human imagination, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who need God's mercy find it in the action of Christians, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this community strive to be of one heart and one mind in the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially for Jerry and Mark Blaha, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Generous God, plant your precious gift of faith ever deeper in our hearts. All that we ask in the name of Jesus, Jesus our risen Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers, sisters, and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept your sacrifice and your prayers. And what grace and glory is in
His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with the paschal joy, every land, every people excels in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace and joy of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Take away all the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should have drunk of my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already in my heart and unite myself to you completely. Please do not ever let me be separated from you. Amen. Those in the parking lot listening to 90.1 and would like to receive communion, please drive your vehicle to the entrance of the church.
Now we'll take up a second collection. The proceeds go towards DCCW. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord. A few reminders before the final blessings. Tomorrow we will conclude the Divine Mercy Novena. As I mentioned, 1 p.m. we will expose the Blessed Sacrament, and then you will have the opportunity to approach the Sacrament of Confession. And then 3 p.m. we will pray the Divine Chaplet, and we will conclude with benediction. So our coming Saturday is our education celebration. It is fast approaching. At the entrance of the church, we have the silent auction basket. So after the mass, those who are interested, please take a moment. And then again, Amanda will sell the ticket for the education celebration. So at the exit, so please approach her. And then we have the Easter gift, the books for the families. Those who have not received one on Easter Sunday, you are welcome to help yourself with a copy. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
So thank you everyone for being part of this Eucharistic celebration. We also would like to thank those who join us through the live stream, those who listen us through the radio 90.01, and those who later participate through YouTube. Thank you, and have a wonderful weekend.
Thank you, Father.
Mm-hmm.
Good news.